change it back.
Not overpowering the transmission of.
Safety features of this Beechcraft 1900, all of which outline on the safety feature cards located in the seat pocket in front of you. In the very unlikely event of an emergency landing, there are four ways to exit this aircraft. The first way is through the main door, which we all enter through. To operate this door, lift the handle while depressing the small red button and push outward. The door will open forward. There are three emergency exits mid-cabin. These overhang exits are marked by red handles, 207, 105. To operate these exits, pull the red handle, the window plug will enter the aircraft, rotate the plug so it fits through the opening, place it outside, exit over the wing and towards the rear. As a reminder, in the event of a cabin evacuation, all passengers are required to leave all carry-on baggage behind. Two fire extinguishers on board the aircraft, one mounted under the co-pilot seat and one in the closet at the front of the aircraft. There's also a first aid kit found in the closet, an emergency locator in the tail of the aircraft, and oxygen system. In the unlikely event of loss of cabin pressure, preparation for takeoff, please ensure your seatbelt is fastened by inserting the middle tab into the buckle until it clicks. Pull the strap sinker on your hips, lift up on the buckle to release. Please ensure your seats are in the upright position with arm rest down. Tables are stowed in and carry-on baggage stored under the seat in front of you. Portable electronic devices which send and receive signal must be placed to off when to airplane mode for the duration of the flight. As a reminder, this is obviously a non-smoking flight which also prohibits the use of electronic cigarettes. Thank you for joining us this morning. Nick is just on top of the stairs. He's going to check seat belts, make sure those of you sitting in the emergency exit are comfortable with that. And we'll be on our way. Once again, welcome back.
Are you willing and able to this for us if we need you to?
Probably, yeah.
Awesome, thank you. And there's nobody seated in the rear one, so those of you in the back, you can kind of follow along just in case you might need to know such a thing. If you hear us request you to open these doors, take a look outside the window to make sure there's no spinning propellers or other hazards, things with fur and teeth, for example. Then push this seat forward. You can help her out by leaning forward. And then you grab this red exit handle, grab and pull it in towards you, pull the door in, turn it sideways. Okay, thank you.
I'd rather just stay in the plane with the eyes.
You're on the right track.
Just like the hotel. Just the ground power unit at well. Right. AC electric. Right. 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 Right.
7, I think you're captain. In the midst of approach here, we're trying to get down runway 27. Unfortunately, I didn't have the visual cues to land on this runway. We're going to try now runway 09 as low orbit amount. So we'll give it a shot. Should be landing in about 10 minutes. 10 minutes if everything goes well. Once again, we'll just make sure your seatbelt's securely fastened for now, and we'll keep you updated. Thank you.
the end.
Yes.
Welcome to Powell River. I'm just waiting on board. I'll secure the aircraft and I'll come back and get you.
Awesome. Hello. First time as well.
At the end of the day for a little tour.
Yeah, that'd be great. Oh yeah.
Built a new one, 18 holes. This one was just 9. They just built a new $200 million wastewater treatment plant right down here. You see, that's just the top of it there. They just finished building that. You can see that. Sometimes you get lots of sea lions down here. You can actually hear them from here. They lay on the rocks down there.
Rocks there, and you can hear them from here. Barking sound.
Are they like, if you're in the water, are they like
car washes? That's the house, that white one there where my mom still lives. Mm. They lived there since the 50s, mid 50s. She's 89 and still lives on her own. My dad died 2 years old.
My nonna also is 89 and lives on her own still.
Yeah. Your mom?
My nonna.
Okay.
My dad's mom.
Yeah, not your. This was the old golf course down here. So I'm going in. Tennis player. I'm actually a certified coach. Played in a few, had some shoulder problems. They do pickleball. Have you ever tried pickleball?
Nope.
That's my aunt's favorite.
Yeah, right here.
Every day.
They got pickleball courts there. They look like they're widely used. Quite an ostentatious property. See the gardens, these all used to be attached to these houses, eh? Hmm. There's the Patricia on the left. See, everything at one time in Powell River was based in the town site. Our courthouse, you see that black and white building?
Hmm.
That was the original courthouse. Yeah. Now it's an inn, but if you want it for your driver's license, it was a jail. There's a theater there on the left.
Oh, cool. And it's still running?
This one here has come back. It's a mall now. It's been redeveloped. This was the original post office here on the left.
Wow.
Brick building in the 40s. And it's now a brewery, townsite brewery.
Mm.
People drinking beer. This was a union hall.
Wow.
This was a bank right here. This hotel here was the original hotel in Powell River. It was built like in 1917.
The park here,
the parking lots were full. It was just unbelievably busy, right? And they had a restaurant in here, and they had rooms. I worked here for 7 summers while I was going to university.
Wow.
They always had well-paying jobs. Those are flumes there. Logs used to travel over this.
Yeah.
This building here was the administration building. You'd line up to get your paycheck before they had direct deposit. Now it's a marijuana thingy. But you can just see the whole thing is just
deteriorating.
Yeah, it's very sad. But that parking lot would be full. Yeah, Dwight Hall. conferences there, community events. They still use it for that.
Oh, is that color?
Probably, because they've tried to make it as historically accurate as they could. And really, another really interesting story here, if you go through this gate and you get by the river, Powell River, the second shortest river in the world, which they dammed, there was a whole community that lived on this side. They were mostly Europeans because it was almost discriminatory. Polish and Ukrainians, they had Russians, they had who worked on the mill, but they actually lived in a place called Riverside, which was a community over here, and they had an old oval, and some of my neighbors, older neighbors that are dead now, they actually lived there in Riverside. And this building here, like I said, was the original hospital. Where I was born, there was a hospital here in that empty thing. Now we have a modern one, but of course, guess where it moved? Everything moved to Westview, like where your airport is, right?
Mm.
So this all changed, you know, as a kid growing up, this town site was a vibrant. It's starting to come back, right?
Yeah,
now it's almost like funky. It's got the brewery, it's got the town site, the market. But you see,
was it a lot busier?
You see these houses here, you can start seeing some of them now, the elaborateness. This whole area in here, they call this the Triangle Gardens. It was a lot prettier back in the day because they would have all gardeners from the mill come up and work on it. And then these beautiful homes at the top there on the left, those were the mill managers. Like, look at the view and everything you have. Look how close it is to the mill, right?
Hmm.
They could just walk down.
Yeah, oh yeah. Then some people wanted more land, so they moved to an area called Cranberry, and where we live called Wildwood. You go over a bridge, it's a 5-minute drive from here, it's very close. But at that time, I don't even think there was a bridge, you had to take a boat.
Wildwood Bridge.
There you can see to the left there, that's where the dam is, to the left here. That's the dam. And this here, I'll just take you down here, there's a nice little restaurant here called the Shingle Mill. And there actually used to be an actual shingle mill here. It was there were a lot of Chinese that were
employed. Oh.
And there was a community that
the lake
you sit inside and you see
the
lake. That's where you go in to get your ticket for the plane.
Have you been on it yet?
No.
It's really cool.
Oh, I've been on the little one from the airport, but not Arbor Air.
Mm.
And people keep their boats here. But the nice thing about this area here, now we're in Wildwood. The lots are bigger, and the soil is very fertile. So lots of Italians moved here.
Wow.
They were working in the mill in the 50s and 60s because they loved the gardening.
Yeah.
A lot of them have passed away. And then some of them that did well moved to Westview, but those large plots of land still exist, right? Like, we've got almost 4 acres. Keep on this road for about another 25 minutes or so, you'll be in Lund. You go through the Quahaman, the First Nations. They have their reserve, their nation, on the way. You can see the yards here. Look at how big some of the yards are, right? Downtown business core. I'm looking a little shoddy. Sada ferry.
Right.
He's from Guelph, actually.
Oh, really?
Ron Woznow was an adjunct professor there. Ron Woznow. W-O-Z-N-O-W. He started, I think it was in chemistry. I think he's got a PhD in chemistry. But he started the Verna J. Kirkness Science and Engineering Program for Indigenous students in Canada. There's about 10 or 11 major Canadian universities across Canada that partner with us. I was on the board of directors.
Oh, that's awesome.
7 cell phone number?
No,
I don't think it's on.
I'm not sure. I can write it down.
Write it down on the card just in case. That's your plan B.
Oh yeah, you gave me your card, is that?
Yeah, but I didn't have it on. It's got only the school number.
I can put down